your grace. And your mercy endureth forever.
Yes.
Now, God, we need a word from you. Speak to the whole souls and minds and hearts of your children. Thank you, God, for your word that is a light unto our path and a lamp unto our feet. Speak to your servant now, God. Bring clarity where there's confusion. Bring healing where there is hurt. Bring love where there is hate. Speak to us now. These all blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. The first book of Samuel, chapter 2. The first book of Samuel, chapter 2. We're going to look at, begin with verse 12. You stand where you have it. You're still trying to find it. I'll see you Wednesday night at the Bible study. It will help your deficiency. Amen. Amen. Let's look at verse 12. Now the sons of Eli were sons of Belial. They knew not the Lord. We jump down to verse 17. Wherefore the sin of the young men were very great before the Lord, for men abhorred the offering of the Lord. But Samuel ministered before the Lord, being a child, girded with a linen ephod. Moreover, his mother made him a little coat and brought it to him from year to year, when she came up with her husband to offer the yearly sacrifice. And Eli blessed Elkanah and his wife, and said, the Lord give thee seed of this woman for the loan which is lent to the Lord. And they went unto their own home. And the Lord did visit Hannah, so that she conceived, and bare three sons and two daughters. And the child Samuel grew before the Lord. Now Eli was very old, and heard all that his sons did unto Israel, and how they made with the women that assembled at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. And he said unto them, why do you do such things? For I hear of your evil dealings by all this people. Nay, my sons, for it is no good report that I hear. Ye make the Lord's children people to transgress. If one man sin against another, the judge shall judge him. But if a man sinneth against the Lord, who shall entreat for him? Notwithstanding, they hearkened not unto the voice of their father, because the Lord would slay them. And the child Samuel grew on, and was in favor both with the Lord and also with men. You may be seated in the presence of God. But if you're hearing this morning from the subject, what kind of child of God are you? What kind of child of God are you? As we conclude this series, The Power of a Godly Family, we began with the question in part one, with what kind of rib are you? Spare rib? That's like a diamond piece or a side chick. Baby back rib, country style rib, or prime rib. Majority of you claim to be prime ribs. Then in part two, we asked the question to the men, what kind of Adam are you? We looked at the ladies' man, Adam, the taken man, Adam. You know, the man that's not yours. Yeah. He owns somebody else. Then the repair man added, you're a cable man. Cool man. Amen. And then the needy man. The man that's needy. Just come on, somebody. Just be with you, let you take care of him. Then there's the man of God. Most of the brothers here said they were the man of God. Then part three, we looked at what kind of family member are you? Y'all remember that? We talked about the Judas family member. You know the family member you can't trust. And the Saul family member, you know the family member that's jealous of you and envy of you even to a point of craziness. Then we looked at the Haman family member who really hates you. They set traps for you. They don't like you, amen. They stay close to you long enough so that they can smile on your face and stab you in your back. Then there's a David family member, the brother, the family member who tries. And there's a Jesus family member, the Christ-like family member. Then on last week, we transitioned for Mother's Day. We talked about Hannah and Lord, open my womb. We looked at the fact that God has, for the most part, closed the womb of most churches, that they're not producing anything. Can I get a witness? They're meeting Sunday after Sunday, but they're really not a womb, they're a tomb. Y'all don't know what churches like that. But as we end this, we talked about the mama, the dad, the family member. Now we're going to talk about the child. Amen. Amen. All those things make up a family. What kind of child of God are you? Jesus taught, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. And Jesus taught, when the disciples came unto him asking, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus called a little child to himself.
Yes.
And he set the little child in the midst of them.
Amen.
And he said, verily I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children, you shall not enter into the kingdom of God. Amen. But it's about saying you've got to become a child.
Yeah.
Whosoever therefore shall humble himself as this little child, the same is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whosoever shall receive one such little child in my name, receiveth me. God loves his children. Amen. If you know something about me, you know I love the babies.
Amen.
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 I hang around the babies. After service, sometimes even before service, they're finding their way to my office. Amen. I made a parent, don't disturb him. I said, no, let that child come in. I let him sit down, amen. I got a big candy jar in there for him. You have anybody, can I get a witness? Want the candy jar? Amen. And can I just take a side note here? The reason why I like to hang around children more than adults is because I can trust the children more. Come on, somebody. That's why I hang around the children. Innocent, fun conversations. Amen. For real spirits. Help me, Holy Ghost. Now, that's not a put down of the adults, because unless you become like little children, you can't even enter into the kingdom of God. Amen. Any children out there? What are the children now? I'm a child of God.
Yes.
I'm a child, amen.
Yes.
Paul taught that the Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit, bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
Amen.
And if children of God, then we're heirs with God, amen. We have what he has.
Amen.
Can I get a witness? And joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, we may also glorify with him.
Amen.
As we looked at chapter 1 last week in the book of 1 Samuel, all throughout chapter 1, and certainly last week with Lord opened my womb, the focus has been on Elkanah and his family. You know Hannah? And how Hannah wanted a baby so bad. She cried and she laid out before the Lord. Can I get a witness? The focus has been there. Hannah, Elkanah, even Penina, who was the other wife of Elkanah. And she used to make fun of Hannah because Penina had children and Hannah didn't. So we looked at that. But now, in chapter 2, it shifts to Eli, the priest, and his family. Throughout this section, you will see a deliberate contrast between Samuel and the two sons of Eli. Their names was Hophni and Phinehas. Amen? We'll just call them Phinney and Hop. Amen? Eli's sons, the Bible says in verse 17, they abhorred the offering of the Lord, which means they misused it. But Samuel, it says in verse 18, ministered before the Lord. Yes. Amen? Amen? So you got the sons of Eli, amen, sinning against the people. Yes. And then you got Samuel ministering to the people. Can I get a witness? Yes. The two brothers, Hop and Phinehas, they committed evil deeds in the tabernacle. And they invited God's judgment. But Samuel served in the tabernacle and it grew in God's favor. You've got some folks serving in the church. And let me just go to the highest level. Amen? You got some pastors that are in danger of the judgment, and then you got other pastors who are ministering to the people.
Amen.
I'm glad this is on Facebook and it's going all over the world. The priestly line would end in Eli's family, but Samuel would be called of God to carry on a holy priesthood. Now, from the human viewpoint, it looked as though Eli's evil sons were getting away with their disobedience. But God was preparing judgment for them while he was equipping his servant Samuel to continue his work. But as we grapple with the piercing question, what kind of child of God am I? Let's launch deeper into our text to find the answer. Because Hannah gave Samuel to the Lord. She left him in the tabernacle so that Eli could raise him. So Samuel became one of Eli's sons. So now Eli's got three sons. You got Samuel, who came from the Lord. And you got the two sons, amen, who were his biological children. They made up one big family in the tabernacle at Shiloh. But let's look deep at the question of what kind of child of God am I? The first kind of child of God we want to look at today is the wicked child. Now, the sons of Eli were sons of the lie. They knew not know. Watch this. Eli was high priest of the Jews. When the ark of the Lord was in Shiloh, his two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, you know, Hop and Phinehas, they were also priests of the Lord. Their office was holy, but their character was corrupt. They touched sacred things. with unworthy man. The incident shows too plainly the vital difference between the spiritual and the official. What are you talking about, preacher? Hop and Finney were officially among the highest men of their day. They bore name, they pronounced all words, they were clothed in emblematic robes, they looked the part. They had the title. They had the official title. Yet, the Bible says that Hop and Finney were men alive. The outside was different. The inside was full of corruption. Is there not a lesson yet to teach us of truth? Is it possible for a man to have a pulpit and to have no God? Is it possible to have the official title of pastor or priest, but don't know the Lord? Yet even here is a mystery, but it's also a strange and wondrous thing. Hop and Finney were officially great and spiritually corrupt. Minister after minister defiling his garments, debasing his name. Professor after professor pronouncing the right words with the lips, but never realizing it in their actual life. Such, my sisters, is the history of the church. In the face of all of this, God still employs people to reveal the truth to other people, to lead them to closer walk with thee. The priest was son of the lie. Well, who's the lie? Well, the lie was another word for the devil. They were sons of the devil in the tabernacle. What was the consequence? No power, no move of God, no expectations, people coming and going. Can I get a witness? And every now and then, God allows one of his children to see it as it really is. Yes. Because if you're a priest and you're described as a son of the devil, and if you are a priest and it says that you don't even know, sooner or later, somebody is going to be able to see it for themselves. Because you can fool some of the people some of the time. But you can't fool none of the people none of the time. You can't fool God none of the time.
Come on.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Sons of the lie. The wicked child of God. And in some families, even in the church family, you want to have a wicked child of God. It seems like a dichotomy to say wicked and of God in the same sentence. Can I get a witness? But some people claim to be of God, but it says that they don't even really know God. Because if they knew God, they wouldn't be doing some of the things that they're doing. Not only do we have the wicked child of God, but we have the disobedient child of God. They knew not the Lord. That would seem to be, Brother Elders, impossible. Because Eli was a holy man. Eli was a priest. Eli was not intellectually a strong man, but morally he was righteous and faithful up to a very high degree. But he was not much a ruler at home. Still, he was substantially a good man. Belial represents corruption, darkness, the devil. Anything that indicates selfishness or corruption of character. Now read the text. The sons of Eli, the holy priest, were sons of Belial, the bad spirit. Eli ought not to have had disobedient sons, right? Disobedient children never come out of a good home, right? The danger is that Eli himself may be charged with the responsibility for his children. 1 Peter 4 and 17 and 18 says, "For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin in us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?" 1 Timothy 3, 4 and 5 says, "A good church leader is one that ruleth well his own house, having his own children in subjection with all gravity. For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of God?" One thing, and those of you who know my children know that my children, I taught them to be an extension of me. Amen. Amen. You didn't act wild and crazy when we was out in public. You didn't act wild and crazy in God's house. Can I get a witness? Because I was so skilled that I could unbuckle my belt, whip it out, and put it on you with one move.
That's right.
And when that psychological threat was burned into their little souls, one look could bring salvation. Just one look. Just one look. Just come in and just take a look.
All right.
Amen.
For real.
They can feel me standing behind them. They out there doing whatever they want, running up and down, you know, just acting crazy. One look. Amen.
Amen.
Because you got a toe up where you act up. Amen. I tear it up in the sanctuary. I tear it up in the bathroom, the fellowship hall, the parking lot, the car. Can I get a witness? The school room. Amen. The hallway in the school. The cafeteria. Wherever you act up.
That's where you get.
Is where you get
toe up. That's right. That's right.
You want to know the Lord. Because as for me in my house.
Yes.
Can I get a witness? We will serve the Lord.
That's
can
right.
I get a witness? So how could this be? With Hop and Finney. They didn't know the Lord. Their lives showed it. You know why a lot of pastors' children don't know the Lord? Because the pastor don't know the Lord. You can't give them what you ain't got. Oh Lord, turn the car on. I need to get out of here. Kill me all over St. Petersburg. But watch this. Samuel did not yet know the Lord either. And his actions showed it also. Remember when the Lord was calling him? He thought it was Eli. Because it said Samuel had not yet known the Lord. But as between the illustrated acts of Samuel and Hophni, so also between the meaning of the words in the two cases, there is as wide a difference as is possible to conceive. Hophni and Phinehas didn't know the Lord and didn't want to know the Lord. Samuel did not know the Lord, but the Lord knew his heart. And when you don't know the Lord, but your heart is after God, God will show up to you. Won't he? Can I get a witness? He will make himself known to you. Help me, Holy Ghost. You got two of the same type of people in the church today. Those who don't want to know the Lord, and those who don't know the Lord but want to know the Lord. And grandma used to say, if you draw near to God, God will draw near to you. There is a big difference between sinful ignorance and childlike ignorance. Yes. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Mama used to say, boy, you know better. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. That's when you really got one of them good weapons. Was one of them, boy, you know better. Yeah. Can I get a witness? Yeah. I just got finished telling you not to do that yesterday. Come on, we went through this all day yesterday. Can I get a witness? I grounded you. Can I get a witness? And now I'm coming up to the school for the same stuff. Boy, you knew better. get here. Come on. Can I get a get here? Because you knew better. Amen. You ain't going to embarrass me out in public with some of the training I done gave you. Can I get a witness? You ain't going to act like this. Can I get a witness? Because you know better. Samuel ministered while the other boys stole. Samuel was very, very young. But Samuel's little efforts to minister to the Lord were precious. And God recorded them right here, himself. Is it only the grown-up, strong children in the family who are noticed and approved of by their parents? Do not your father and mother love the little infant that can but just crawl around? And if it does but put forth its little arm to show its affection, do they not notice it and look very pleased? Let me tell you what I'm talking about. I've had six children, different ages. Oldest, older, don't get her head. You might be looking on Facebook. And then the youngest. The youngest used to do something like maybe just sit up or take the pacifier and put it in their mouth. Amen. And I'd just be going crazy. Oh, yeah. Look at what the older one come along with. Well, I could do that too, amen. You don't go crazy because, amen, there's something about the little infant, amen. And then the older one get jealous. Well, he ain't really doing nothing. I'm going to say he's just standing up. He ain't really dancing. Let me show you what dancing is. Well, it ain't about that, amen. I know you know how to dance. Can I get a witness? But little one is learning how to do it, amen. It's not that I love you more than I love them, amen. I'm just excited at the level that they're at. Amen. But before we start to say, oh, that just happened with little children, grown folks in the church do the same thing too. Why the pastor just getting out this song? It's all that good and everything. He just went crazy, just praising and everything. You know, can I get a witness? All right, so she wore a dress today. All right, so maybe I'm going to dress every Sunday. Amen. But you don't know.
That's right.
What it took for them to get there. Yeah. Amen. Can I get a witness? It might be easy for you to put the pacifier in your mouth. Come on, somebody. But this child might be, come on, an autistic. Amen. Come on, and you got spiritually autistic people in the church. And so you gotta give them praise when they do something, even though you know you doing it and you doing it well, like, man, and maybe you didn't get praise, but you don't know what it took for them to do it.
That's right.
And to accomplish it. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Yeah. Well, my parents was that way too. But I learned to have them get child and the disobedient child God. You have the hard head. Child. Anybody got it? Hard-headed one? You know what they say? A hard-headed. Tony was hard-headed. I guess I was too sometimes. Look what it says. Now Eli, who was very old, heard about everything he was doing to the God and how they slept with the women who served at the entrance to the tent of the meeting. They have women, amen, that used to be ushers. Can I get a witness? Serving the Lord, trying to perhaps get closer to God. Who knows what they've been delivered from, what they got saved from. But now they're in the church, trying to get closer to God. And the priest Eli said to the sons, why do you do such things? I hear from all the people about these wicked deeds of yours. He said, no, my sons, you shouldn't do that. The report I hear spreading amongst the Lord's people is not good. Eli said, if one person sins against another, God may mediate for the offender. But if anyone sins against the Lord, who will intercede for them? Amen.
Amen.
You've got to either be crazy or wicked, or crazy and wicked, to fool around and break the heart of one of God's children. You won't get away with that. Can I get away with this? I better move on. I got a whole sermon on that. However, when Eli told them that, his sons did not listen to their father's rebuke. They were hard-headed. For it was the Lord's will to put them to death. Help me, Holy Ghost. Since Eli was an old man with failing vision, he left the work of the tabernacle to his two sons. And they took advantage of their father by doing what they pleased. You've got too many church leaders doing what they please. And then they're too arrogant when you approach them about it, to humble themselves. Because see, pride comes before the fall. You can't be hard-headed because God will humble you. You can't go around mistreating God's children. Because God will humble you. And perhaps maybe we've had to learn that lesson. But learn the lesson. Hop and Finney did not personally know the Lord, but they were sons of the devil. They were hardened. They were reared the right way. Eli reared them in the temple and taught them about the things of God. But you can go to school and get as many degrees as you want and be official, but still not know the Lord. Help me, Holy Ghost. They not only show disrespect for the sacrifices on the altar, but they also had no regard for the women who served at the door of the tabernacle. Instead of encouraging them in their spiritual walk, the two brothers seduced them. These women were not official servants appointed by the law, but they were volunteers who assisted the priests and the Levites. Perhaps they helped care for the little children who came with the adult worshipers, or they may have been there just to be close to the presence of the Lord. But ministerial immorality is in the news all the time. And it's a tragic thing, but it's really nothing new. Can I get a witness? It's hard-headed. It's one thing to go through a storm that God will send to try to get you back on the right path. But it's another thing not to learn the lesson that God intended for you to learn. The least you can do is learn the lesson. Can I get a witness? The least you can do is say, Lord, I'm sorry. Amen. I made a mistake. I'm human. Amen. I'm trying, Lord. Amen. That's the least you can do is learn the lesson. But to be told about the wayward path you're taking and to ignore it is a whole other thing. That's when you got to do, you got to turn them over to the Lord. You ain't got to do anything. All you got to do is turn them over to the Lord. Might not even be your place to do anything. Amen. Because look, to whom much is given, much is required. Can I get a witness? God ain't playing, because you know, you got to be careful when you take on an official title in God, but your heart is not right. Don't take the title. Can I get a witness? Don't play with God. Leave it alone. Help me, Holy Ghost. Just go on about your way. Go on about your business. Don't play with the things of God. Because sooner or later, hardened. Sometimes that could lead, really most times, it's going to lead to a sad ending. It's not going to be pretty. And God is saying something to the churches today about the move in my church. Because there are folks that are offending the children. Those who will come to grow. Those who come to hear from God. Those who are sincere. Amen. At the altar, trying to get closer to God, trying to get their lives together. Amen. And the last thing they need is to come to the church and get hurt.
Amen.
Or not be. And somebody better be bold enough to say enough is enough. Amen. I don't mind saying it, because I don't want nothing from none of them. Can I get a witness? I got a pulpit to preach in. Can I get a witness? But when you come, you want to get the truth about it. Come on, can I get a witness? I'm going to tell you exactly what God said. You might not like me.
Come on.
You might ostracize me, but that's okay. I'm still standing. But somebody's got to be bold enough for the truth. Amen. Because it's like there are too many hard-headed church leaders. Too many wicked. too many disobedient, too many hard-headed. But besides the wicked child of God, besides the obedient, disobedient child of God, besides the hard-headed child of God, it is the growing child of God.
Amen.
1 Samuel 22 and 26 says, and the child Samuel grew on and was in favor both with the Lord and also with men. Samuel is growing up in the same house as Hophni and Phinehas. He knows Eli's eyes are now getting dimmer. Amen. And Eli can't see. But Samuel ministered. Amen. And I'm saying to the young people today, you're going to have a whole lot of hop and fitties around you.
Right.
They're going to be joining gangs. They're going to be stealing. They're going to be fighting. Can I get a witness? But don't you be like that. You do what God tells you to do. Don't fall for the peer pressure, amen? Because Hop and Finney, amen, you know they were stealing the jewelry, they were stealing the offerings and probably buying nice jewelry with it, nice chains around their neck, amen? Maybe they were driving a car, a nice fancy car, and it seemed like they were successful. But you just keep on doing what you're doing.
Amen.
You just keep on being a child of God.
Yes, yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
After a while, amen, you're going to see Hop and Finney probably in the news. And God will help you, and God will strengthen you, and God will use you.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
You have to get it right. Because if there's going to be any kind of rightness in the house of God, there's got to be real children of God in the house of God.
Yes.
Was Samuel perfect? No, he wasn't. He did not yet know the Lord himself yet, but he was after God. Amen.
Yes.
He was serious about it. He wasn't playing with God. Help me, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
He knew that he was a miracle.
Yes.
He knew that his mama was barren, but God opened up her womb.
Yes.
And she promised the Lord, Lord, if you open up my womb, I'll give Samuel back to you. So Samuel knew that he had purpose in his life. You are a chosen generation. You are a child of God. Can I get a witness? You ain't meant to be shackled. You ain't meant to be in prison. You ain't meant to be shot. You ain't meant to be sweat. You meant to be somebody special in this world. Can I get a witness? And I'll be ding-dong if I'm going to let anybody. Trust one of these little babies. Bob said it's better that you tie a big stone around your neck and threw yourself into the Gulf of Mexico before you touch one of these little children. The growing child of God. Don't necessarily have to be a perfect child of God. But they ain't going for all the things that's happening around them. They're saying, focus on the Lord. Can I get a witness? Stop worrying about what anybody else is doing. Samuel wasn't worried about what the sons of Eli were doing. He knew that sooner or later, God was going to take care of it. Help me, Holy Ghost. He made sure that he stayed on the right path. He did his homework. He went to school. He obeyed his parents. Can I get a witness? He did ministry, whether it was ushering, singing, dancing. He was ministering unto the Lord. He was somewhat of an apprentice priest, learning the work of the sanctuary, and even wore a linen robe that his mama made for him.
Amen.
He was dressed just like the adult priest. He was a junior deacon. But what made my boys so successful is that I challenged them to be the best that they could be. Amen?
Amen.
I didn't accept mediocrity. I didn't accept average. Amen? I challenged them. But one thing I also did, I modeled for them the type of men they were supposed to become in God.
Amen.
to the best of my ability. I wasn't perfect either. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But I showed him what a real man of God looks like. Come on, help me, Holy Ghost. I baptized all my children.
Amen.
Help me, Holy Ghost. They came to the Lord on their own volition. Help me, Holy Ghost, and I'm thankful. Help me. I'm thankful. I'm thankful unto God that he blessed me enough. Amen. To look, look, look. I ain't saying I was always perfect, but when I was around my children, especially my boys, I tried to be what they were supposed to be. What God had made for them to be. Help me take that life seriously, even as a pastor. Help me, Holy Ghost, because I know how the devil is so busy walking around seeking whom he may devour. He wants to steal, kill, and destroy. The sons of Eli were sons of the devil and got a hold of them. Help me, Holy Ghost. But what the kids need is to see somebody who's walking and talking. Can I get a witness? Somebody who's doing what they preach. Somebody who's practicing what they preach. They need more example.
Yeah.
Samuel was an example. Outside of walking around in that little road. And out of shame and awareness. Because he's a child of God.
Amen.
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 Each year, Hannah would bring him a new garment.
Right.
Because he was growing. Can I get a witness?
He
had to get some more clothes. Amen.
Yes.
He had to get some bigger shoes.
Yes. Yeah.
Because he was growing. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
How many know that God will get bigger for you when you grow? Amen. Same clothes that you spiritually last year shouldn't be the same clothes that you should have outgrew, amen, your arm, okay? Tell me, Holy Ghost, I need more. I'm grown now.
Come on.
Can I get a witness? The girls after a while, they didn't want no more rats in there.
Yeah.
Paul, I should have been dead and gone for some of the things I did. But I am a child of God. Be patient with me, because God is not through with me yet. I know that Jesus, amen, was crucified and hung for my sins.
Right.
Can I get a witness? He was bruised for my transgressions. Help me, Holy Ghost. He was bruised for my iniquities. But I followed Jesus all the way to the cross, because it was at the cross where I first saw the light. And the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith that I received my sight. And now I am happy all the day. So be careful how you deal with me. Be careful how you treat me. Be careful how you hurt me. Can I get a witness? Because I'm a growing child of God. I may not be where I ought to be. And I may not be where I'm going to be. But thank God I'm not where I used to be. Help me, Holy Ghost. God knows all about my troubles. And God knows all about the things that I've gone through. But is anybody here can relate that I am a child of God? How you talk about me. Be careful how you scandalize my name. Be careful how you act around me. Because God is watching over me.